full of unclean lips. And this is when the miracle occurred, because one of the creatures took a burning coal from the altar, came down and touched his lips, and he said, "Your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven." I want you to walk out of this church today knowing that you are not insignificant. I want you to walk out of this church today knowing that you are worth it. I want you to walk out of here today feeling grateful for the fact that God created you, and that God created unique gifts and possibilities and talents in each and every one. It is not the intent of this congregation, of this minister, of this minister, of this organist, of this soloist, of any of us people. It's not our intent that you should walk out of here today feeling less about yourself than you should. And as he was there and he was fully appreciative of the fact that he knew that God loved him, he heard God ask this question. God asked the question. He said, "We have something that needs to be said. We have something that needs to be communicated. Who can we send? Who will go? Who will speak this message?" And Isaiah stepped forward and he said, "Here I am. Send me." Now, this is an unusual kind of twist for God's call in the Bible as we know it. Because in most instances where we have encounter situations where people are encountered by God and God says, "I want you to do something," what is their usual reaction? "Oh, you can't mean me. Not me. Moses, I want you to go and do something." "Oh, you can't possibly mean me. I stutter. I'm not the man." Over and over. "I'm too young. I don't know. I'm not fit, I'm not capable." And in the midst of all this rejection, unworthiness, comes Isaiah. And Isaiah steps forward and says, "I'm the man. Here I am. Send me." I love that attitude, because it's not dependent upon God asking you, it is dependent upon you stepping forward to say, "I will do it." Ramona and I have a grandson, as most of you know. His name is Marl. He's 2 years and 4 months old. And between all of the biological grandparents and step-grandparents, there are 8 of us all together. And we all live in a 5-mile radius. And I tell you, the grandmother competition is stiff. Yes. And a couple of weeks ago, we had Morrow for the day, and we decided to take him. It was a nice day to take Morrow and our 2 dogs. There's a couple miles away, there's a nature trail. We thought it'd be nice to go and walk around this trail. And we did that. And it had been raining quite a bit in the last couple days, so we came to several places where it was muddy, where there were puddles in the way. And the first couple ones, Morrow kind of tiptoed his way through. But we finally got to some that were a little overwhelming to him. And so he looked up at me, and this is what he said. Now, he calls me Bobo. You know, with 8 grandparents, you got to be creative, is what you call each one. So we're Momo and Bobo. And he looked at me, and he held up his hands, and he said, "Bobo, I need to hold you. I need hold you." This is the attitude of Isaiah, wasn't it? "I need to hold you. I need to do your will. I need to do it. I'm not waiting around. I'm not begging. Oh God, please help me." We're such whiners sometimes, aren't we, with God? "Oh God, what am I going to do? Please help me. Please give me this. Please do this for me. Please, please, you know, oh, I don't know, you know." I can just imagine God like, "Just stop the whining. Stop the whining. Stand up for yourself. You're worthy. Say what it is that you need to say. Bobo, I need to hold you. And Isaiah said, I will do it. Here I am. Send me. Now, I don't know that perhaps in your family, in one of your relationships, maybe a couple of your relationships, I don't know in your place of work, I don't know in your neighborhood, I don't know. But I do know this, that there are several times, maybe each week, that something happens, and deep inside, you hear this voice that says, somebody should say something about this. Somebody should do something. Somebody should offer a word of encouragement. Somebody should help. Somebody should do this. I tell you, that's the call of the Holy Spirit. That's the call of God. There's a message that needs to be proclaimed. There's something that needs to be done. Who's going to do it? Who's going to go for me? And whenever you hear that voice that says, somebody needs to say something, somebody needs to do something, you step forward and say, here I am, Lord. Send me. I will do it. I will say it. We need to be a lot more bold with our faith. We need to be a lot more assertive with our faith. We need to look up to God and say, oh God, I will do it, instead of being a woman. Here I am, Lord. Send me. Let's go. Oh God, there's so much that needs to be said, so much that needs to be done in this world, and sometimes we are caught just wringing our hands. But today, oh God, give us strength and courage. Give us boldness. Let us know beyond the shadow of a doubt, as you have through Jesus. Let us know that you love us, that you care for us, and that we can do things far beyond our imagination. Like Isaiah, we know who we are. We know that we're not perfect, but we also know that you forgive and you love and you make us whole. We thank you so much for Jesus today. We ask this in his name. Amen.